TV10 and WRNR are proud to bring you this episode of Law Enforcement Live, recorded on the 13th of October, 2020. Thank you to Berkeley County Sheriff Curtis Keller for allowing us to give you this look into a day in the life of a law enforcement officer. This episode will feature two motor vehicle incidents.
Law Enforcement Live is filmed live with the men and women of law enforcement. All participants in tonight's show are innocent until proven guilty in a court of law. Viewer discretion is advised.
My name's John Jeffries, deputy here with Berkeley County Sheriff's Office. I work here part-time in support to help the guys out. I'm here just on a temporary basis while other deputies are on deployment in the military. I started in law enforcement when I was 17 years old. I joined the 157th Military Police Company here in Martinsburg.
Oh, wow.
So I've been doing it since
1990.
That's a lot of experience.
I've had a few years under my belt, but the job it kind of gets in your blood. You enjoy doing it, and when you don't do it, you kind of miss it. So you kind of learn to like it all, and of course there's different situations that you deal with, but for the most part, I enjoyed doing all of it.
Where I copied. Oh.
There's one round the vehicle there that is obstructing traffic. Can you get some of these next time? Yes, ma'am. Good.
That's my husband's truck. He ran out of gas, and he had to go to the doctor. So I came here I just called him right now. He's right there. He just couldn't push it by himself.
All right, so let me ask you this.
Yes.
So where is he at now?
He's right at the doctor's office at the end of the stop sign to the right. But I just got off the Shepherdstown exit, not knowing he needed my help, and then he called me from there and said that he was pulled over on the side of the road. And I said, well, you can either sit in your car or you can miss your doctor's appointment. He's on Suboxone. He had to go to the doctor's or else he was going to be out of medication. So it was more crucial than people realize, I think.
I've got a tow truck on the way here.
Okay.
Because it's obstructing traffic.
Yeah, I get it.
So, you'll want to deal with him. I'll let you know who's coming so you can get that.
You don't know yet the name of the company?
They haven't told me yet. So,
all right.
But do you live in Shepherdstown?
Yeah.
Do you have your identification?
Yeah.
173 building.
Okay.
Which doctor did you go with?
Garcia.
Garcia, just straight up.
Screaming at him because he can't go without his medicine, and he got stuck at work today and wasn't able to make it on time. And it was like 4:50. I have it on my phone. My mom said, "I'm not going to make it." And I said, "You can't not make it. They're not going to see you, so you can't not make it. This is more important than a freaking truck moving on the street, unfortunately."
Yeah.
Hey, I'm talking to the officer now. What? Casey, I'm talking to them now. Alright, but it's going to take you a minute to walk over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in the street.
7-1 from Christian Carter.
Stop that.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm
going to
try
to
get She's coming back to Allen.
Just come over here.
Expiration August 2022. And see if any warrants are negative.
My ID's good.
Okay, full break.
I'm not a felon.
Yeah, that's going to be the way for this subject. You left his vehicle here. He's heading to the doctor's office, right?
Yeah,
he's aware it's going to be towed there. We're just waiting to right now.
Thank you.
So we'll just wait on the tow truck. And you got Les's coming.
Who is it?
Les is. He's right. He's located right
he
now.
He probably knows him. He's from here.
Yeah, Les has been around for a long time. So, yeah.
So. Some money we have to dish out unnecessarily.
All right. Well, we'll just wait on the tow truck here, and I'll be back with you when they get here. Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Gas. I got a can.
Well, considering the fact you're right here, Chad.
I mean, I get it, but by the time the tow truck gets here, I'm probably gonna get out of here. I go to Sheets right here. I was literally right there at a doctor's appointment. I was already late, so I tried. You know, nobody will help you if you're out here. So I was trying. It was in the road. Nobody. I couldn't. I was pushing out of the road myself, and I'm lucky I got it there. But I can literally be back in 10 minutes for that truck gets here.
I got it right here. It's because of the COVID stuff. The copy got broke, but I got it right here on my phone. I got a weird circumstance.
Like a
your county,
you have
a
favorable for
an assault, number 10, 10 10 Calabash, I don't know what y'all can do, whatever, but I told him, you know, I'd already contacted you, and the gentleman's over here with the water.
Tell him to wherever the facility is charged.
Oh, I understand that. All right, well, let's go over here and talk to him real quick.
You still have to pay attention to our civil fees.
I'll talk to him right now.
I mean, our insurance has road, I mean, we have full coverage on his truck. I just paid it today. So I don't know, that's something that they would.
Then had a mail come on the line that all was okay and went flying to the sector. Unable to call back for 911.
I mean, you ain't gotta do that, buddy. I already know how much it's gonna be. It's gonna be $100.
127 dispatch failure, screaming and yelling in the line got disconnected.
I can find out how much it would be. You got somebody taking care of your fuel?
Yep, I got you right there.
Okay.
He was just waiting for me to get here. It's just that I couldn't get here fast enough.
Okay. I'll buy
and it's in the middle of the street. I mean,
I'll buy down and take get it all directed far enough for you.
All right. That'll work.
Just to get it like over here. Should I go get gas now? I already pulled it off that top.
Oh, good.
He's going to need it anyways, either way.
Hey, what it is, this guy just ran out of gas. They're calling us because it's kind of in the way. He's got a gas. Yeah, he just ran out of gas. Yeah, he's moving it. Alright. 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 He says his friends come out here, we're just charging $40.
That'll work. Anybody pay with a card?
That's the cash.
Chris!
That'll save a lot more than have to be towed.
Yeah, it's in such a place right now. It's like it's,
yeah, if we can get him off the ants, off the road a little bit.
Yeah, it'd be nice if we could just.
Yeah, I don't know, we can pull him that far.
There's an ATM right beside the gas station.
If we can boost you off the road a little bit more so we can get this traffic.
Yeah.
He's going to pull up, help push me right there, and he's going to charge $40 service fee for that coming out. So he's going to get the gas right there. He's just going to come back here.
Which $40 a lot better than $100.
I didn't want to leave it. She made me leave it.
Yeah.
So, but she said she was coming. That's the only reason. So she said she would sit with the target. Yeah, he's gonna help me push it up by the
partner. I'll push it.
Go ahead.
This thing is heavy.
I'm going to offer completed here at the FJ. I'm 10-8 to 10-15, 10-19 to pay for.
I got it off myself.
Really?
All right.
did that at home house or anything. I did it by yourself, ain't it?
Yeah,
I got it off the road, but there was no way I was getting it any further.
Yeah,
she's just going to sheet right there, so she'll be right back.
Alright.
She'll be right back with you.
Like,
I think I was wrong with my gas gauge. Like, I was in a hurry. I wasn't on empty
to float.
Probably. I never run out of gas either. Glad I had a can back here.
Yeah.
I almost made it. I was on going right there. And I sat here for 15 minutes.
But that's bad on the fuel pump.
Here for like 15 minutes.
What am I going to do? And you get somebody going to fly down the road.
Yeah.
That really wouldn't have been good.
No.
It worked out better than I
Well, I was leaving the doctor. My wife was on her way here to sit with until I got back. I was talking to the doctor. She was calling me. I said, shit, man, somebody done ran into it.
Well, they've been off the road. Yeah. You know, not stuck it out like the time.
With the way traffic is here this time of day, like I came to a complete stop, man. It took everything I had to get it from there to there. I got in the doctor's office. I was so tired.
Well, you got a long wait here. Especially next week, Max.
I'm going to move my trip here all the way.
Yeah, that way you get
good to go.
All right, buddy. I appreciate it. Have a good one.
Gasoline. Traffic limit is completely shut down.
Berkeley 143.
You did.
143, did you need anybody else other than state police notified about that vehicle?
Thank you. his head bypasses 2 years ago.
He's lucky he didn't get hurt.
All right, so
I've seen him flip.
Give me a few minutes and I'll be back with you guys.
Clearly, the guy in the white pickup truck pulled out in front of the he pulled out in front of the dump truck, so he's going to be at fault for the accident.
Yeah, he's lucky he didn't get smashed.
He's extremely lucky that he didn't get hurt out of that. It really messed that truck up. Bad.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God he's okay.
Good to go ahead and load that Ranger up and get out of the way.
Yeah. There's a insurance on the
Help getting out on the road there.
stay here until I start traffic. All right,
thank you.
I gave the driver of the white pickup truck a citation for, he didn't have right away. He pulled it out right in front of that dump truck. And then I cited the driver of the dump truck because he didn't have a proof of insurance. I believe that he had insurance on his vehicle.
Berkeley and Spader County unit available for assistance on the progress 800 block of Tesla Road Pike.
So who had to bring that in? But thank God nobody got hurt. That could have been a lot worse.